Joining us now with more on this, science educator Bill Nye. Bill, it's always a pleasure to see you. It's very difficult times that we're talking, you and I, about today. But Milton went from a tropical storm to a Cat 5 in just over a day. Hurricanes are nothing new, but this level of intensity is so unusual, Bill.
It's unusual and scientifically interesting, but very, very troubling. My heart goes out to, our hearts go out to everybody who is affected and will be affected, not just by what's happening now, but what has happened. I mean, they're probably going to retire the names, both Helene and Milton. It's so serious. So here's the striking thing. The hurricane is coming from the southwest going to the northeast, not from the southeast going to the northwest. And it's going in to a part of the Gulf of Mexico that has this extraordinary thing called the loop current. And it reminds me very much of gears spinning together, where one gear drives the other gear. And so the hurricane naturally has a counterclockwise spin in the northern hemisphere through this remarkable thing, the Coriolis effect. And then it's getting amplified by the spin of the sea right there, the Gulf of Mexico. Now, you've probably been to Clearwater, Florida. And Clearwater, Florida gets its name because of the way the sediment settles, because of the way the current spins through there. Well, this current is going to help amplify this hurricane, and it's even going to spin off tornadoes on the outer edge. I mean, this is a very, very big storm, and the whole thing is driven by the heat of the ocean in the Gulf of Mexico. I mean, everybody's been talking about this literally for decades. Well, here it's really happening so quickly. This warm water provides all this energy to these storms, and the cool air, the relatively cool air around, drives it up. The water vapor comes out of solution as rain. The heat is released at high altitude, and this causes the spin, and the spin of the Earth causes the whole thing to go around. Now, look, Jose, you know, when it comes to things like space exploration, I do my best to be political but not partisan. Where do we apply our intellect and treasure, right? And when we're on MSNBC, and very happy to be here, big fan, we are talking to people who are generally like-minded. But anybody out there who has young voters in your world, in your family, this is it, everybody. The other side, as we often call it, has no plans to address climate change, no plans for long-term dealing with these sorts of problems. If you have young voters out there, encourage them to vote. People say, what can I do about climate change? If we were talking about it, associating it with big storms like this, that would be really good. But the main thing is vote. Thank you.
And Bill, very quickly, how much of an impact do you see climate change playing in all of these explanations that you've given us? How much do you change as being a part of that?
Oh, it's no question, everybody. Look, there's no, in climate science, everybody has been studying this for years. Everybody has been commenting, scientific papers have been written about how warm the ocean is around the Florida Peninsula. And it's this warm, warm water that is driving these storms and enabling it to have to intensify so quickly. Everybody, be careful out there. Let's get through this.